Yes!
Welcome back to my channel. I'm gonna do another episode of Video Game Roastrespective.
Oh no.
I play retro video games that are based on movies and television shows and other intellectual properties from the past. Please like and subscribe to my channel.
No way, I wanna rock!
Yeah! Live reactions every Thursday on Twitch at 10:30.
You talk! You dumb!
Check out all my social media stuff right there. If you haven't checked out any of my other videos,
not my style,
please do so. I'll post some links in the comments. And if there's any games you'd like to see me play on upcoming episodes, please leave those in the comments as well.
I don't believe you.
I thought I'd get into something that is considered a classic franchise. I think that everyone is pretty familiar with.
Jason should have been watched every minute.
The Friday the 13th video game.
It's definitely going to be a thrill ride for the fans. They're really going to enjoy it.
Very spooky NES music. I don't know why there's no image right here.
Yo, man, it's cool. It's cool, man. It's cool.
Camp Crystal Lake, right here.
Should never have opened this place again. There's been too much trouble here.
There's the Crystal Lake, where Jason Voorhees famously drowns.
Don't you remember? Remember, Jason.
Mark, Paul, George, Laura, Debbie, and Chrissy. I'll just pick the first guy.
Don't go out there!
Oh, there's a countdown on children. Is that children dying? Or the camp counselors?
Nobody wants to die.
Go into the cabin near the cave. Who left that note? Is it Jason's mother? Go into the woods. Who's leaving me these notes?
The boy, Jason.
It has Jason on the cover in the hockey mask, which the hockey mask doesn't even appear until Friday the 13th, part 3. Jason Voorhees died at Camp Crystal Lake as a child. And then the mother completely blames the fault of the camp and then swears revenge and goes there and murders all of the camp counselors.
Kids ain't nothing but trouble. They don't respect others' property, and they're all crazy.
But then it later on went a more supernatural route. And somehow the reanimated corpse continued to grow older, I guess.
No!
Jason was kind of a one-man army. I don't know who all these zombies are.
Please welcome Jason.
Oh, there's Jason. Oh no.
Oh my god.
You can't just take on Jason. What are you, crazy?
And if I get him first?
You and your friends are dead. Camp Crystal Lake is incredibly perilous. There's so many other things just besides Jason. I don't remember Jason ever being in a cave.
Do you remember very much?
It's definitely a franchise that kind of evolved or devolved, depending on how you look at it.
You don't understand. There is a maniac trying to kill us.
Oh, Jason is in here? I'm like terrified. He's gonna jump out. Oh, there he is. Oh, he killed me with one shot. Oh, Jason's in here too? God damn. Jason's everywhere. Oh, there he is again. Jason's doing a lot of broad daylight killing. Which isn't very common in the movies. He gets one or two in during the day, and then he just gets to night stalking. Camp Crystal Lake always seemed like such a weird place. Like, it does, you know, I don't even know how you end up sending your kids there. There was never anybody, like, in charge. It was always just, like, a bunch of kids showing up there to work.
I want this loony bin closed down. You hear me, fella?
Jason was always, like, holed up in some nearby shack. That's what this looks like. Oh, we gotta take the boat. Oh, he's in the water. Oh, here he is. Oh, he just hacked me with the machete in front of all the kids. That's why there's normally not kids at the camp yet.
Okay. I told you this isn't funny. Now you're gonna get it, bitch.
There's like 10 installments of this. A modern update, plus the Freddy versus Jason film also.
Yeah, that really scared the shit out of me.
The story never changed that much, just kind of, even the location didn't change much for a while. They kind of became parodies of themselves after a while. Jason Takes Manhattan is a very underrated Friday the 13th film. I think that one is so funny. All they did was just up the kills, or like the kill count and the brutality. I don't really think any of them are really all that scary. I guess they were like scary when I was young, but I like the idea of a Friday the 13th game. I don't know if this is the greatest representation of that, but at the time,
hey, where do you think you're going?
I have to go fight Jason in front of the children. It's just me and one kid. So realistically, if I stayed here, Jason would just come here, right?
Yeah, well, the game's not over till it's over.
Yeah, that's right.
Stupid Jason. Dirty bastard. Game over. That's pretty fun. Seems pretty straightforward, but you're at Camp Crystal Lake, Jason's chasing around camp counselors, you gotta save kids. There's not really much more to Friday the 13th. I had already gotten to where it was just Jason the killing machine. So this is a good representation of where the series was at that time. I had a good time with it. I would definitely play it again. Jason's Voorhees is a lot like Ernest. Like, the best one is when he goes to camp.